Let's discuss about Coulomb's law, which is one of the important law in electrostats. About this law, we can state that this law gives the interaction force between two static and point charges. This law is mainly used to find out the force between two static and point charges. If there are two point charges Q1 and Q2, we know that like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other. So if these both are positive charges, these will repel each other with the force magnitude F. And say if the separation between the two charges is R. According to Coulomb's law, according to this law, we can state the magnitude of force is directly proportional to the product of these two charges Q1 and Q2, and the force is also inversely proportional to square of the separation between the two charges. That means it is an inverse square law. And here if we combine the two expressions of proportionality, it gives F is equals to K Q1 Q2 by R square. And in this situation here, K we call a proportionality constant. This termed as electrostatic constant, which depends on medium in which the charges are submerged. Value of K we are going to discuss in detail step by step. Here you just keep in mind that the value of K depends on medium, and for free space you can just write down the value. We'll also calculate it and see how it is calculated. The value of K is written as 9 × 10⁻¹. It is used in SI units. And if you just deduce the units from here, it will be Newton meter square per Coulomb square. That is the unit used for the electrostatic constant. About this constant, we'll discuss in detail in later part of this chapter. Let's discuss the vector form of Coulomb's law. As we have studied that if there are two charges Q1 and Q2, separated by a distance r, and if say we denote the position vector of charge Q2 with respect to Q1 as the r1 vector, and the force experienced by the charge Q2 is F vector, and that experienced by this Q1 is F dash vector. In this situation, we know that these two are equal and opposite forces, as the action reaction forces are there. So we can always write that F vector is equals to negative of F dash vector, and in magnitude as these are equal. Here we can write that F vector, which is acting in the direction of this position vector R1. Here we can write it K Q1 Q2 by R1 square multiplied by R1 cap. That is a unit vector in the direction of Q2 from Q1. This is the magnitude of force, and this is the unit vector in the direction of F vector. And this can be further written as F vector. We can write, if we substitute the value of unit vector, it is vector upon its modulus. So this will be K Q1 Q2 by R1 cube multiplied by R1 vector. This is the way how we vectorially represent Coulomb's law. And F dash vector can be directly written as negative of F vector. This negative of K Q1 Q2 by R1 cube multiplied by R1 vector. This is the way how we write the other vector. Or we can say in either direction, if we know the position vector of one charge with respect to other, we can calculate the value of F and F dash. So be careful about these expressions of Coulomb's law in vector form.